While the glory of college football is earned every fall.
We here! Yeah, we here! Yes, we here!
The blueprint for success is mapped out in the spring.
Keep playing me! What I just called, coach?
And for Johnson C. Smith University.
One, two, three. Go, Bulls!
What's up, buddy? Let's go.
The Golden Bulls head into year two under head coach Maurice Flowers. Looking to turn last season's handful of close losses.
Last season, we lost six games either by overtime or the last series of the game. That means we're real doggone close.
Into the backstory of a powerhouse football program.
Our goal right here at JCSU is we're getting ready to be a CIAA power and Division II national contender. That's our goal.
As the Charlotte, North Carolina HBCU continues to bloom within one of the fastest growing cities in the nation.
To see the growth that Charlotte has taken on, knowing that Charlotte has went from a place where it was truly basketball area. You know, just basketball was where all attention was. And then to see how it has shifted to where football takes such a high priority, not just in this area, but really nationally. If you look at some of the top teams in the country, you'll always see them in Charlotte recruiting. And you'll always find rosters with people from Charlotte on them.
There's some things that can only happen at Johnson C. Smith University and in the city of Charlotte.
Today's a really exciting day for the Carolina Panthers as we welcome the Johnson C. Smith University Golden Bulls for a special practice event here at Bank of America Stadium. Gert Field on campus is undergoing a transition to synthetic turf, which has left the school without a practice facility for spring practice. And so we're really excited to be able to assist them during spring practice by making Bank of America Stadium available for them today.
You just say it's a dream come true. Hey, I'm a Charlatan. It's a dream come true for me to have our young men get an opportunity to practice in the NFL stadium. The turf that we're getting ready to practice on is the actual field turf that's going in at Eddie McGurk Field. So we're looking forward to, as our construction winds down, to a great practice today in this great facility and then moving on to our campus field. You want to be a winner in this town, and that's part of what we say when we're recruiting. This is Johnson C. Smith University in Charlotte, and we have a lot to offer. There's some things that can only happen at Johnson C. Smith University and in the city of Charlotte. And this, you can't get this anyplace else.
We just got to know the way the storm is tracking right now. The earliest that we'd be able to go out, the earliest would be 6 o'clock. So we're so far off schedule, so really disappointed that it didn't work out. But hopefully y'all had an enjoyable diversion coming over here today. You got one day without running really hard.
Yes, sir.
It means a lot for us to share the day with y'all, so continued success this week.
Thank you so much, Ryan.
Yes, sir.
Change a losing program that has been a losing program for a number of years. It does not happen overnight, but at the same time, you don't accept losing. And so when you have to look at where you are and then where you're going. So we've had to look at our 2-7. That's painful. We really can look at how teams celebrate. You can look at it at the end of each game when you have teams celebrating a win against Johnson C. Smith. That's something that you don't want to happen again. Over the past 20 years, the record is like 48-120. And so why do you go there and feel like you're going to change it around? It's because you have a plan, and it's because of your location, and it's because of the commitment of the university and private donors. And when you have that, you just know and you can feel that the change is coming. And our young men, you know, having played the games that we played last season and being so close to winning and really taking it upon ourselves to know that we have to get better. We don't call it rebuilding, we call it our building of a program. One championship in the CIAA, and that was in 1969. One CIAA championship at Johnson C. Smith. And our young men know it, and most definitely the gentlemen that play on that 69 championship team, they let us know it also. So we're looking to go do something about it.
My mentality is I gotta be a dog out there. Like, it's either I catch the ball or nobody catches the ball. My name is Jaden Lockhart. I'm a sophomore at Johnson C. Smith. I went to Philip O'Berry High School out of Charlotte. Since we're all young, we all hungry. We all have one goal. And you never know when your opportunity is going to come, so you got to make the most of it.
The love of football, you know, it just comes out of it. Having that energy of like, you know, I'll rock for my brother, do anything for my brother, doing whatever it takes for my brother. My name is Gerald Nathan Jr. I'm from the city, and my position is linebacker. The senior year came around, I wound up getting hurt. After I got hurt, Missouri called. Fell in love with the environment, all the glitz, the glamour, and I was like, yeah, I can do something with this, you know, and I wound up committing. The whole staff that was at Missouri, they had left after that season, and then they came in with new staff. They brought in their recruits, and that's just how business works. Hopped in the transfer portal. I had got a job at FedEx, started working at PepsiCo, contemplated if I wanted to come back to the game or not. Feel like God told me it's time to come back to Charlotte. Didn't know why. We rode past the school. He just pulled on campus. I didn't know why he pulled on campus or anything. He just pulled on campus. Went to the athletic department, and Coach Flo and Coach Tripp was here. He said, you still trying to play? I said, hey. I said, you present me an opportunity. I'm here. And that's how it happened.
Work on me. Work on three. 1, 2, 3. Work.
Tyrell Jackson from Greenville, South Carolina, quarterback. It was never really about going D1. Just going for the perfect place for you, and that's where I felt it was. I really don't say much on the field, but I'm in the film room. I watch a bunch of film. That's how I play. Coach Flowers, he's very hands-on. He knows his offenses. He made it himself, so he knows all the ins and outs. He wants it to done a certain way because that's how he made it.
Not just twist.
My name is Aquarius Smith. I go by Jack Smith. I'm from Lakeland, Florida. I'm a middle linebacker. I'm a junior going into my senior year. A lot of competition in Florida. I found myself committed to Syracuse, and then I decommitted to Syracuse, and then I committed at the University of Purdue. I played in a few games. I played in against Minnesota, and I played against Auburn. We had our bowl game my freshman year. I got injured, like, from being a starting guy in high school, and then now you got to sit back and watch. Like, it kind of messes with your mental as a football athlete. And then you be like, dang, why I ain't playing and you want to play and stuff? But then you have to realize, like, your day gonna come, your opportunity gonna come. I had to just take a mental break from school, so I took a year off and became a truck driver at FedEx. But, like, it just always felt like something was missing. It's just like when I'm on the field, I feel free. Like, I can do anything. Like, I can fly. And I got in touch with Coach Tripp and then Coach Flowers. While I was working at FedEx and driving trucks, we was talking on the weekly. I had to handle a few things in the process, and I handled those things, and I told them I was on my way.
We revamped our playbooks to make sure that we cut some things out to help our young men be able to play faster, and we saw that. The big thing that we wanted to see was the team that finished the last game of the season was our team that took the field in the spring. Are we better than that team? And it's very easy to see that we're a better team that finished the season. And we're bigger, we're stronger, we're faster, we're smarter, and we're more aggressive, and we're just more confident.
Every single play, do what you are told to do. Do your job. Do we understand you?
They go 12 personnel right here. We're going Jet Vice. Lock them up. Get your outside, whoever the anchor is. Load it up.
Good, clean, and business. Here we go. Go Bull Pride on three. Go Bull Pride on three. 1, 2, 3.
Go Bull Pride!
Good luck. That was stacked right. Hold it. Hey, go Charlie if it's 2x3. That's going all the way. He better catch the ball.
Oh my God.
Miami.
Backside, gotta handle it, man.
Y'all
backside,
just figure the block out. It's a give on this one. I'll come back and let you know if it's gonna be oozing heat check. Okay.
Eyes up.
Sumter Wright River, Atlanta State. Let's go. Oh,
in there.
Rush!
go right. Yes, great effort, Tyreek. Great effort, Tyreek. Here we go.
Oh, Lord.
You know what it is.
Without even watching the film, too many pre-snap penalties and too damn slow. Too many pre-snap penalties and too damn slow. It's a first and goal on the half inch or fourth and one, we damn going. Period. It's inches, we got the damn goal score. Attention to detail and playing with a sense of urgency is not where it needs to be right now. We're gonna pick that up. Pre-snap penalties, are you kidding me? That's just mental attention to detail and focus. Those are the things we're gonna concentrate on now. Now, overall, not bad. We know we can do some things when we turn it on, but there's some base things that we gotta be able to do. We'll get it better. We'll get it better. We'll get it better. Here we go, see position killer. Big O on three. One, two, three,
Big O. What you should have picked up today was one. I can't just run in when I get ready because we play tempo. If we substitute, they get the substitute. We're playing tempo, we don't want them to substitute. We want to take advantage of a misalignment, right? Or fatigue. Run the ball back to the umpire so we can play with tempo. Don't throw the ball out of bounds. Don't celebrate the first down. Because we're playing tempo, you're helping them when you do that. You're gonna get coached out here. If you can't take coaching, you need to do something else. RB's on three. One, two, three.
RB's.
Gumball's ready.
Yes, sir.
Break. Woo! Gumball Pride on three. One, two, three.
Gumball Pride.
Hey, good afternoon, man.
Good afternoon, coach.
Good to see you. Good to see you. Hopefully, everybody had a good day of classes as we get ready to crank up and roll out this afternoon. Once we break up from here, offense will be going to lift, defense will meet. Then we'll flip-flop, pre-practice at 6:30, flex, TTO. That TTO today is short yardage goal line period today. We'll have 8 plays. 4 gold, 4 blue, then we'll get to special teams. We'll have special teams period right after that. Then that group period, we'll go blue right here for 4 plays, for 3rd and 3 for the minus 33, and then we'll go gold for 4 plays. Gold, blue will go first, then gold. Okay, that's the practice schedule for today.
Hands on the ball! Ready! Go!
That's the same weight room I lifted in 1987. Maybe the equipment's a little bit different, but it's not any bigger. You're not gonna get more than 20 or 25 in there at a time. That's a true dungeon. Our strength and conditioning coach does an outstanding job. Our guys aren't just in the weight room, they're outside the weight room. That was never even a thought back in the days when I was playing. So we're taking that space that's the main part of the weight room and we're actually extending it. And that just comes from the imagination and just the advancement of sports performance.
Big O!
We utilize what we got. We're hitting the plyometrics, we're doing our auxiliary lifts, and then our major lift is always in the weight room. So whether that's front squat, bench, or regular squat, power cleans. Over here on the side is where we utilize our auxiliary lifts. So our auxiliary things are right here. Then we got the hurdles for hip mobility and things like that. And then at the end, we all do core together. You win the games now. You don't win them in August. You don't win them in September. You win them now.
Let's go.
Yeah.
Hey, man.
I wouldn't be here if administration wouldn't have a new weight room that was in the plans. And I'm looking forward to us moving to the new facility, new weight room, new locker room, new coaches' offices, new study hall areas, new meeting room areas that really are going to put us on the same level as other top Division II schools. I mean, it's easier to recruit when you have good facilities. We're not going to have a problem recruiting top student athletes to come to JCSU. And when you do that, you're going to see the quality of the product on the field go up also. And so that's, it all works together. And that's what we're doing. You're going to see the continuing of the building up of a program.
Hey, come on, man. Just keep it up, man. Keep it up.
It can't move too fast for you. If it were Plum, he snaps it. He goes to the left. He takes the front side A. You have the back side A gap. You have the other linebacker. Tell me what's confusing about that.
Let's go. Bullets, Vegas.
Are you?
No. Sit. Hey. Come on. Sit. Hey. That's why you ain't never catch no pick before. They threw it to you about 3 or 4 times last year. Let's go. Blazer. Set. You got a cone on the back, right? So if the back is here, I can fake rush, right? Y'all ready? Okay, let's roll. So I'm going to fake rush, and then I got him. Fake rush, then get back. Let's roll.
Yeah, let's break it down. Hey, fast, physical. Let's fly around. Let's get it. Hey, family on me, family on three. 1, 2, 3.
Family. Let's go, baby.
Don't grab it. Don't grab it. Yeah, we playing football.
You know how we slide.
Hey, Tisa, get some more split, bro. Tisa. TV, a little bit more split.
But this is what I'm saying. How can I keep, I know the trail here and just keeping this foot, but I done did that before. If you look on film, this foot is straight and my hand right here. So what can I do?
Got to keep concentrating on that lock hand right there. Keep concentrating on that lock hand right there. And by the time he get even with me, he ain't got to turn it on.
Set, shake your hips.
Set. Dominate on me. Dominate on three. 1, 2, 3. Dominate.
Right there. Pick that. Ah! Hey, you got peek. Where's the hinge?
It doesn't matter.
Once I hinge here and there's nothing in the flat, I got a peek and I'm trying to win it.
Yeah, he did a comeback. So I was underneath the comeback, right?
So if I see him there, I can plant
this way and I can undercut it, right?
Let's go. Here we go.
Joe Barbecue Foot Massage. Joe Barbecue Foot Massage. Joe Barbecue Foot Massage. Joe Barbecue Foot
Massage. That's why I'll be getting beat right now.
Man,
what? What are you talking about?
Don't be mad.
We have something going on. What y'all got going on?
Watch out, go to Bulls, come to a city near you.
Let's go.
We here all day.
Right.
Let's go,
right.
Baby. Hell yeah. Right. Hell yeah, three.
Three, 1, 2, 3.
Put the fire out, get off the field. Let's go.
Hey, hard work on me, hard work on 3, 1, 2, 3.
Hard work.
Miami, Nashville, and he played man. Hey, base.
Good spring, man, a good spring. Lots of improvement and lots of areas for us to improve upon also. And man, it's gonna be a good summer for the Golden Bulls, and we're gonna have a great season in 23 as we build this thing forward, man. It feels good to be a Golden Bull. You should be proud. You should be proud. You should feel proud. Nice dang on crowd for a damn gold and blue, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
New look, boys.
One time.
Work hard.
Improve every day. Be the best.
Be the best.
No excuse.
Refuse to lose.
One heartbeat. Golden Bulls ready?
Yes, sir.
Break. Woo! Here we go. Golden Bull Pride on three. 1, 2, 3.
Golden Bull Pride.
Hey, man.
LB.
Hey, you looking at the best edge rushers in the conference? Hey,
I'm on now.
I swear.
We're winning everything. Hey, bring it up, hey man. Hey, Jazzy on me, help us, we gotta get T. G, hey, big on me.
How y'all gonna get T? Hey, bro, I can't get T.